What's good, everyone? What's good? It's your boy, JTL. Back with another one, so let's be honest. All right, so I'm sure a lot of you have heard, so I got to get my interpretation on it. So TikTok famous twins, I believe their name is Sway and Allie. The one on the left is Sway. You can see she got the, let me blow it up a little bit. She got the tattoo on the neck right there that says 20. The one on the right is Allie. And the brother on the right, God rest his soul, was their stepfather. So I'm hearing different stories. I saw O'Shea Duke Jackson video, and he said that it was because their dad went over there pleading them to stop twerking online. Come to find out that was not true. I did a little research, and come to find out, so allegedly the sister on the right, Allie, had got $500,000 from what I don't recall hearing, and the sister on the left with the tattoo 20 on her neck, Sway, was mad about it. So her boyfriend was over there and they got into the altercation, and I guess the sister Allie on the right called their stepfather over. So they got into a physical altercation, and then the their stepfather got into it with Sway on the left boyfriend, and they said that they was pointing guns at each other. Then they said, I don't know, I guess they had a shootout. The father got shot, and then the punk ass boyfriend ran off. But unfortunately, another young sister, 23, I believe, she got shot. She's in the hospital in critical condition. Then her dude found out about the shit, and then he went looking for them in their apartment, I guess, and fucked around, kicked down the wrong door, and shot a 73-year-old man to death who was on dialysis and a breathing machine. God rest that brother's soul. So this is why it's so many different things I'm about to bring up. This is one reason, I'm sorry to say, I know a lot of sisters are going to get mad, but oh the fuck well. This is a lot of reason why you hear a lot of brothers saying that, especially when it's women like this, stay away from women who are ignorant like this. Stay away from dealing with women who may be ghetto as fuck, may be ratchet, may be ignorant, may be masculine because of a situation like this. It's all fucked up. Like, this type of ghetto shit is the reason why a lot of brothers saying stay away from sisters like that. Now, not all sisters are like that, we know that, but the problem is so many women, so many of our sisters in our community are starting to be raised a lot like this, man. So you have here a brother that helped raise these young girls. These are not his children. Their real father passed away. I didn't hear from what it was, so I don't know what the situation was that he passed away from. But this brother right here helped raise them. But kind of find out, he might have been a little ghetto. No disrespect. God rest the brother's soul. But to go over there, get into a situation because apparently the other sister on the right, Allie, had came into $500,000. And the sister on the left was mad about it. So when they got put into the police cars, well, they wasn't really arrested. They could have been arrested, but they was detained. And the reason why I know is they was detained because when the sisters was in the back of the police car, the first one on the left, Sway, her sister on the right, Allie, came to the car, was like, you green for what happened, this your fault. And she was like, you know, the sister in the car, Sway, was like, she's gonna go on live. She was in the back of the police car going live with her phone. The other sister, Allie, on the right, ended up being detained as well. She went live again because she went live showing her dad bleeding in the streets. It's crazy. If y'all wanna go look at the actual footage, you can go to Famous Twins on Instagram and you'll see them. Look for these two. It's a couple different ones, but you'll see the ones and you can go and see the footage and stuff that's on there. If you want to see, it's very graphic. So the one on the right, y'all should be about to take a look. The one on the right was crying over a day. He was bleeding out. Police was trying to talk to him. And the one on the left, when she was in the police car, she sounded like she had no fucking remorse. She did not care. All she kept saying, how that bitch gonna get 500 racks and not share with her own sister. She ain't got nothing to say to me no more in life on my mama. She didn't say shit about her daddy, stepfather getting killed. So this is so many situations. So you got one young nigga on the run. Two, because they looking for the other boyfriend who shot the elderly gentleman to death in his own fucking apartment. He on the run. So you got the stepfather dead, you got a 73-year-old elderly brother dead, then you got another sister that's in critical condition right now. look at all this shit, man. Look at all this bullshit because the bitch got a few dollars. Is your soul really worth that? So now you hate your sister for life, but this is your fault that your stepfather is dead. It's your fucking fault that a young lady's in the hospital in critical condition. It's your fault that a 73-year-old brother got killed in his house that had nothing to do with it because her stupid-ass boyfriend shot the other dude's girlfriend by accident, and he busted in the kitchen, somebody doing shot this man to death. All because this bitch on the left with a tattoo on there, I don't give a fuck how nobody feel. Because you mad that a bitch got, your sister got a couple dollars. But this is the ratchet shit because they showed them in the car riding around with the blicky, telling me they'll shoot somebody in the car because of road rage. This is this ratchet ghetto shit that sisters need to stop. And I just did a video about Shikara Richardson smoking weed and fucking up her Olympics chance, where she may be able to get to do the 200 meter relay. This, come on, man. This is the ignorant shit that we're talking about. So many brothers, like, yo, we got to stay away from shit like that. And it's understandable. It's understandable to be careful, but you got a lot of brothers that be on some ratchet shit and think they can control it, but they actually support it and condoning it. And that's another thing with a lot of stepfathers. If you're going to be a stepfather, be a real fucking stepfather, man. Don't be with this ghetto shit. This ghetto shit hurts everybody. All because these heifers out here wild or not, having fun, thinking it's all good. And then, allegedly, there's claims from one of the videos that a neighbor was saying that they was trying to petition to get these heifers out of their neighborhood because there was so much ghetto and ignorant shit going on daily that they wanted them out of the neighborhood. This is a black neighborhood, and they wanted them out. You know what I'm saying? So these are things that we have to consider about when it comes to life, man, and this ghetto shit. Sisters gotta stop being so ghetto. Our brothers gotta stop with this ghetto shit, man. You see what it is. It's either jail or death. One or the fucking other. And that's what we gotta realize, man. We gotta do better. It's your boy JT, opposite from the norm. You know I had to be honest. We'll be back with another one. Chill.